Hello, drivers. My name is Dean Kretzinger. I am the regional manager for CPC in the Shippensburg-Inwood area for P&G. I want to welcome you to my YouTube channel, Just Call Transportation, something I started up in Wisconsin a few years back, and I like to use it to, you know, give all my drivers information. Today it's going to be, trying to make it short as I can, we're going to have a few DOT, we'll talk about the DOT 72-hour blitz, some equipment write-up changes at Shippensburg, time off requests, and logs to ELD, or logs, ELD, paper logs, questions and answers on that one. So first we'll start out with the DOT 72-hour blitz. That's Tuesday, May 17th. Make sure you're doing your pre-trips, your post-trips. Check them good. This year it's about the wheels, brakes, adjustments, and so just, you know, do a really good pre-trip, post-trip. We have great equipment, but it still needs to be looked over. And another thing I wanted to bring up was, you know, that a lot of you seen guys out there, they call them the Texas drivers. I can't inform you, they're not spies. I have worked with them for years. But what you will notice, the reason I'm bringing them up is they always do a pre-trip, they always do a post-trip, they always open that hood, getting in, getting out of the truck. And if you need help doing a good pre-trip, post-trip, just get with one of them. They'll help you out. But they are not spies, so they're here to help when we're shorthanded. You know, they could end up in Dayton or another P&G area, or sometimes some of our other clients, they help them. So make sure you're doing a good pre-trip, post-trip. The next thing is the equipment write-up changes in Shippensburg. You know, we had Jimmy Stoy was doing it all. It's getting really to be too much. So we're going to add Royce Foreman. Him and Jimmy are going to work together to help get our equipment in and out that needs to be PM'd, worked on, or whatever. They are not managers. You know, I've talked to both of them. They know that. They are actually volunteering, and they're helping you guys. So the more help that you can give them, the better. The more communication that we have, the better. I mean, it's, you know, they're there to help you. Or probably next week, Monday or Tuesday, I'll have some cones up there. We're going to have a certain place we put them at, but I'll send an email later once we get the procedures down on how we want to do it. But you also need to make sure you're using the website on any write-ups that we have and leaving notes in the truck. But I'll touch on that with an email next week once we get that locked down. Time off request. I've had a lot of questions on this. Want to make sure that's when you have a, say you're wanting May, you know, or say June 15th off, on the start date and the end date, it should be June 15th. If you put the 15th, 16th, it's going to show up on the calendar as you want 2 days off. I know many of you have probably had that issue where you thought you were coming back to work after your day off and the planners, the dispatchers thought you were off. So make sure that start and end date are the same. And on a PTO day, just a personal day, I would like 7 days notice before you take that. I know things happen sometimes, I understand that, but keep that in mind for the 7 days. That's for our planners. And for vacations, I need 30 days. That's not asking a lot, because I know a lot of places we've always asked a year in advance to know when you're on vacation. So 30 days is very good. Vacations do not roll over. So a year after you earned it, you lose it. So make sure you use it or you cash it out. We go by your anniversary date. We do not go by, January 1st. And when you send in the check, the requests, I try to do them in the AM on Monday through Friday. Every now and then I'll do them on Saturdays. You should get an email showing that it was approved or not. And if you don't get one of those in about 5 days, shoot me an email, because we had a hiccup last week where the managers were not getting the request, and then we got pounded with them in 1 day. So, you know, reach out if you don't see that within a few days. If you put it on a Friday afternoon, it's probably not going to be looked at till Monday. So just keep that in mind. ELD to paper. So when your ELD goes down, you can either use the app, the Keep Trucking app, or paper logs. You must have paper logs in your truck. Everybody should have them. When you start work here, we give you a logbook. I will make sure I get some extra ones in the Shippingsburg shed/office. And yeah, I'll get those in there. But if you get in the truck and it's not working, use your paper. Make sure that you send an email, take a picture of it, send that to me and payroll. You can get the information for payroll on the website. Or you can just email it to me and I will forward it to them. But if you do forward it to them, I like to be on the email just so I can make sure you're getting paid for it. In the DOT rules, it says you have to have access to your last 7 days' logs. I read that as, yeah, we can email them to you. That's access. You don't have to actually have them in your truck. Back in the paper days, yes, you had to always have them with you. But now that we can email them to you, you do have access. We can get them to you right then when they're asking for them. But anyway, I kind of went over that quick. I don't like to make the videos very long, but you should be able to use this link and look at the Just Call Transportation YouTube. I got a lot of videos in from when I was in Wisconsin. You'll see one of our managers up there now, Kurt Ryan. He was the safety supervisor back then. He's in most of the videos. I was always behind the camera. But anyway, you can go look at that. We have some bloopers. But sorry for the fishing shirt here. I used to be an avid fisherman, and I don't anymore. I actually did some tournaments and it was a lot of fun. Maybe some other day. I can say that fishing is safer than snow skiing. That's a fact. But anyway, I appreciate you watching the video, and I will see a lot of you Monday, Tuesday next week. Thank you.